Hi, this is Michael Buffer, and you're watching
Dante's Boxing Nation.
Caught with a great shot in the beginning. He's all jacked up. What's he gonna do? He's been hurt. But when I looked at the tape, the shot he got hurt was boom. The shot that he didn't see coming. That's why he got hurt. And he dropped twice. So you gotta give Andre kudos for that. You know, he's proven, but now it's his chin, because his chin was saying what Sergey's gonna hit him with. So it's the flip side of that. What can Andre do once he gets hurt seriously?
What about Sergey's left hand? Bernard said Andre's gotta watch out for the right hand, but let's say Boyd does something to take it away. Can he beat him with the left as well? Hurt him with the left.
Yeah, that's what we worked on. Two hands attack. You can't just go in with one hand against Andre. It's not, you just won't go far. So definitely we have a two hands attack. And if he doesn't look up for the left, the look hook, or jab, or whatever's coming at, stays in trouble.
Hey John, do you think Andre's past his prime? You think that he, the last four or five years of inactivity, moving up to a fight of this magnitude, kind of swings things in your face? Yeah. You talked about that before.
Yeah, I think he's past the plateau where he was here on top the last 5 years. He's on a downward slide, but it's not in deep decline. But he's going there. Because if you watch how he was 5 years ago, he was really smooth. He was really fluent. And had that same movement now. So he's starting to climb, but not a bad, not where it's really visible to a lot of the naked eye. But he's at a point now where he can't be caught. He can't be caught. If he gets caught by this guy, it's lights out.
He brought in Shieldstone. He did a couple different things different for this training camp. You think that means that, you know, he's going to try to use a little bit more movement than he has in this past couple of fights?
Well, he might be a little more movement. It might be a little more stamina, but listen, Mickey, I mean, he's not a boxer. He never was. He worked with good fighters, but in the end, it's what the fighter has inside him that's going to make him win. And Andre's a very good fighter. I can't take anything away from him. But this fight here is a little bit more dangerous for him because the power that Sergey possesses, can he withstand it?
You don't expect him to grapple a lot and do a lot of the clinching techniques?
We're prepared for that. We worked on that definitely because that will, listen, once he gets hit with a good shot, every fighter, I don't care how good you are, what kind of plan you have. Once you get hit by a really good shot, that changes your whole perception of the fight. Now you go back to what you did best. You have to. That's your survival instincts take over.
John, what do you think of Andre saying, I think during the HBO piece that, or not during the HBO piece, but his media day, that he's showing his hand by talking?
I can show my hand to it. It doesn't matter. When you get hit, what are you going to do? See, I'm just talking. When you get hit by this guy, what are you going to do? It doesn't matter what I do. It's what you do in the ring that dictates win or loss for you. And he's been hit by a couple of good shots. Been hit by this guy. If you ask anybody that spots Sergey, can he hit? Well, they're going to tell you, they'll probably tell you, turn that mic off. They'll tell you what's really going on. But this guy can punch. We'll see what he can take once he gets hit by the power of Sergey Kovalev.
Well, on the media day, show a lot. Was that on purpose to not show your hand, like to not show it?
You mean as far as the boxing part?
Yeah.
We never do that. For what? What are you missing? It's something more, media is so on hand these days. If you get a film, you can say, I never do my guys. I don't want you. I'm not going to play my hand and show you what I'm doing. I might talk some trash, but I'm not going to show you what's going on. You'll find that out from fighting.
Hey, Jackson, how did the Kovalev relationship even come about? Like, how did you guys meet and all that?
Well, one day I got a call from his manager, Agus, and he said, I'm sending you a fighter. Now, the difficult part about that was when we got together, there was no one for he and I to speak to each other. I didn't speak Russian, he spoke no English. So it was kind of tough in the beginning. But, you know, boxing has its own language, and we worked around that, and it began to work for us. And, you know, we definitely came together, and we're a very definitely good team now.
When in boxing, they say that a good boxer always beats a good puncher, but does Sergey have such freakish power that it kind of it equals out that saying, that analogy of life in boxing?
You know, that statement is somewhat true, but the one thing with this fight here, you have to realize is Sergey can box. He's a very intelligent fighter, and we worked on things that allow him to cut the ring off, and he takes the face of the fight. So for him, that saying is not so much of a problem for us.